Good evening, I'm Brittany Nielsen. We begin tonight with a special remembrance and commemoration for a group of men and women often taken for granted and who suffered through one of the Central Coast's worst accidents 50 years ago this month. With more on the local stretch of highway dedicated to the Braceros today and the story behind it, here's Action News reporter Tom Miller, who joins us live from Salinas. Tom.
Brittany, the Spanish term bracero means manual labor, and that's exactly what this estimated 5 million Mexicans were for the United States agriculture industry. But many times they were exploited, and things reached a tipping point following this terrible crash.
The date was September 17, 1963, when on these very tracks in Chular, tragedy struck.
It was late in the day, like 4 o'clock in the afternoon after work.
After a day spent harvesting the fields, more than 50 workers boarded a truck and headed home. Moments later, they were hit by a train at a railroad crossing. The death toll eventually reached 32.
From then on, they called that crossing the 32, which meant the 32 who were killed.
John Macias was a sophomore at the time, just down the road at Gonzales High. 50 years later, he's here to celebrate the Bracero legacy, one that's being marked by dedicating a 15-mile stretch of Highway 101 between Chular and Soledad as the Bracero Memorial Highway.
If you look at the history, Braceros more or less made that corridor, Salinas all the way to King City and Greenfield. So it's very overdue, in my opinion.
Much has remained the same in the time since that fateful day. The wind's still here, as are the tracks. The fields are off to the side, and the men and women who work them are often still overlooked.
People think that, well, they have no skills. You know, anybody can work out in the fields and pick lettuce or the Salinas or the strawberries from Watsonville. But they're skilled workers, and I think we have to be thankful every dinner time when we go and eat our vegetables.
Now there's a new generation of braceros who face many of the same challenges, with housing, pay, and job security still in limbo. This memorial brings those issues to the forefront, highlighting problems of the past still in existence today.
And this was not the first accident or abuse that the workers suffered through, but it was the biggest, and it kickstarted an effort to end the worker program. Just 1 year later, it was over. Brittany?
Tom, thank you very much. Now, more than 100 people attended a ceremony today to learn about and honor the Braceros at the National Steinbeck Center in Salinas.